بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I wanted to record this video for Dr. Craig Considine and his followers on social media. So Dr. Craig, he has amassed over 138,000 followers on Twitter. And I don't follow him on social media, but I very frequently come across his posts because Muslims share what he says all the time. And if you look at those who follow him on social media, you'll find that it seems that the vast majority are Muslims. They have Muslim names: Muhammad, Abdulrahman, Abdullah. So it seems that this non-Muslim man who makes posts speaking about Islam amassed a huge following of Muslims. So I wanted to talk about that, why I think that is and why that is something we should be concerned about. So, number one, I think that he amassed such a huge following of Muslims because he says nice things about Islam. And since he's a non-Muslim, speaking highly of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and saying nice things about the Quran, it makes us feel good because we're so used to non-Muslims doing the opposite, speaking very negatively about our religion. So seeing a non-Muslim speak highly about our religion, it makes us feel nice. It makes us feel a bit more confident about coexisting in a society with non-Muslims, and it's something that we appreciate. So I can understand that. I think a second reason why he was able to amass such a huge following of Muslims is because we are hoping that he embraces Islam. When we see non-Muslims saying things like they believe that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a real prophet and that the Quran is from Allah, we're hoping that Allah guides this person to Islam and that they accept the religion, because this is the greatest blessing that a human being can ever have in this world, is Allah guiding them to Islam. So I think we're all hoping that he embraces Islam. But I also think that there is a third reason, unfortunately, that many Muslims follow him, and that is because we have somewhat of an inferiority complex. So when we see a white, non-Muslim, American speaking highly about our religion, I think for some people it makes them a bit more confident. It makes them feel a bit more secure about their religion to have someone like that talk highly about their religion rather than somebody who's already a Muslim from another country, who isn't white, who doesn't have doctor before their name. Unfortunately, I think that this is also something that people, even if it's subconscious, suffer from. So I think those are three reasons why he was able to amass this huge following. Now, why am I recording this video today about him? Well, over the past couple weeks, couple months even, I've been seeing posts from him. People have been retweeting things that he says. And although some of them, they're very nice, he says nice things about Islam and the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, some of the things he is saying is wrong. It's misguidance. He's overstepping the boundaries. He is misinterpreting verses from the Quran. He is misquoting the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is saying things about Islam that are not true and are actually very dangerous, and those who follow in his footsteps and are influenced by his way of thinking and his interpretation of Islam and the Quran and the Ahadith, they can be led astray. So it's reaching a point where Dr. Craig, he needs to be formally invited to Islam. He needs to be checked by some of his followers for some of the misguidance that he is spreading, because we are the ones who are giving him this huge platform. We are the ones who are following him on social media. We are the ones spreading his quotes and the things that he's posting, and it's reaching a point where he's amassing such a huge following that he can make a career out of this. He can publish books. He's getting invited places to speak publicly about Islam. He is becoming a well-known, famous figure of authority with a wide audience based on the fact that we are uplifting him and supporting him and spreading the things that he's saying, even though, unfortunately, many of them are not only incorrect, but extremely dangerous. Things that can lead one away from Islam. So for example, just yesterday, he posted something where he is spreading this theology of perennialism, where he is trying to portray Judaism, Christianity, and Islam as being all three accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That one isn't necessarily better than the other. And this is very dangerous because it is not up to us to speak on behalf of Allah. It is not up to us to say what Allah will or won't accept. What we do is we hear and we obey. Allah is the one who sent guidance to us through the Quran. He is the one who sent the messenger, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we submit to the guidance that Allah sent to us. Islam is not a religion where we sit there and try to, you know, just spread our opinion about things. Allah tells us that the only religion that He is going to accept is Islam. That's it. We are living in a time where the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent over 1,400 years ago. It is upon us to follow the last messenger that Allah sent. It is upon us to follow the last scripture that Allah sent. That's it. This is what Islam clearly teaches. So Dr. Craig, he claims that he believes the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a prophet. He speaks as if he believes that the Quran is from Allah. So if that is true, it is upon him to accept Islam. These other teachings that he is spreading about Islam, it's not from the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So either Dr. Craig is claiming that he knows better than the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or he is just very misguided and doesn't understand what he's saying. And if that's the case, we need to correct him or stop following him, because he is spreading misinformation. And when we spread misinformation about Islam, it's not like spreading misinformation about other things. This is the most important thing in the world. We're talking about the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're talking about divine guidance that leads one to eternal paradise. And those who reject it, those who try to change it, these are things that lead one to eternal hellfire. This is not a game. This is not a joke. This is something we have to take very seriously. So Dr. Craig, if you believe in the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you believe in the Quran, please take your testification of faith, become a Muslim. And to everyone following Dr. Craig on social media, if he refuses to accept Islam, if he continues speaking about the religion in a way that is unbefitting, because he is saying things that are completely contrary to the Book of Allah, to the message of the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, to the teachings of Islam, then we need to make sure that we are not giving him a platform, that we are not supporting him, because we are making him stronger. We are giving him a career. This is becoming a career for him. He is the non-Muslim guy who says nice things about Islam. So people invite him to talk. People follow him on social media. People are gonna buy his books and go watch his lectures. And this is a direct result of us supporting him and encouraging him. So I think it's reached a point where, okay, we've appreciated the nice things he said. We've been making dua for him, hoping that he embraces Islam, but now he's taking it too far. He's saying things that he has no business saying, and he's starting to spread misguidance amongst the Muslims who are following him. And this is something that is unacceptable. So hopefully, I pray that Allah guides him. I hope that he takes his shahada and he becomes a Muslim. Otherwise, we need to respond accordingly as Muslims and not give such people a platform. Jazakum Allahu khairan. Allah surely knows best. Barakallahu feekum. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.